Imagine, every single day, millions of radiation-treated flies swarm down from airplanes upon the helpless nation of Panama. This sounds like a corny disaster movie plot, but it is not. It's a real-life, decades-long effort by the United States government to protect livestock from an enemy so tiny, you might not even notice it until it's too late. The New World screwworms' flesh-eating larvae can have devastating impacts on livestock and wildlife populations. And in the 1950s, researchers came up with a plan to stop the havoc they were wreaking. A plan that involved planes, millions of sterilized adult screwworms, and eventually, Panama. A plan that, despite how strange it is, remains our best bet to this day. But hopefully, not for much longer. Found primarily in North, Central, and South America, the New World screwworm is a fly, not a worm as their name suggests. Their entire life cycle is pretty short, around 21 days, and they can travel several miles from their original birthplace. This means that this little fly can become a big problem very quickly. The females lay eggs in the wounds of mammals like livestock, deer, and sometimes even humans. The newly hatched larvae, which do look worm-like, feed on the tissue, causing significant damage or even death to the infected creatures. In the 1930s, screwworm infestations were a really big problem in the United States, costing the southwestern U.S. livestock industry millions of dollars a year in animal losses. Farmers tried all kinds of ways to control the infestations. They shifted livestock breeding schedules to colder months when screwworm activity was minimal to keep newborn calves safe from infection. They also tried moving wound-causing procedures like branding and castration to colder months. Unfortunately, none of these efforts were effective or sustainable. The screwworms just kept reproducing, and it became apparent that the bugs couldn't just be controlled, partly because they could just hide out in wild animals. They needed to be eradicated completely. Enter the sterile insect technique, developed by United States Department of Agriculture researchers and implemented in the 1950s. It involved sterilizing laboratory-raised screwworm flies using gamma radiation and releasing them into the wild. Gamma radiation causes DNA mutations, and depending on just when you apply it, it can cause big problems for the flies, in the exact way researchers want. There's a sweet spot for treating the flies, around 5.5 to 7.5 days into their life cycle. If you choose that time to blitz them with gamma rays, the mutations sterilize the adult screwworm while keeping them healthy and none the wiser about their inability to make babies. The sterile adults are then introduced into the wild, where they compete with fertile flies for mates. Since the female screwworm only mates once in its short lifetime, one attempt with a sterile partner means you're out of the gene pool. The first successful application of sterilized screwworms took place in Curacao. 400 sterilized flies per square mile were dropped by air onto the island, and eradication was confirmed around 10 weeks later. After this successful trial, planes filled with sterilized screwworms flew over the southeastern U.S., releasing millions of sterile adults into the wild and leading to the complete eradication of the decades-long U.S. screwworm infestation in 1966. And that was the end of that. Except, not quite. Unfortunately, that's not where the screwworm story ends. But first, all science needs funding, so let's take a quick break. This SciShow video is supported by Brilliant, an online learning platform crafted by people on the front lines of tech and education at Microsoft, Google, MIT, Caltech, and more. Brilliant doesn't mess around when it comes to your education or when it comes to keeping you engaged. Each of their lessons is filled with hands-on problem solving, from puzzles to case studies, so you get to be actively involved in the learning process. You can start building understanding from the ground up at brilliant.org/scishow, the QR code, or the link in the description, and you'll get 20% off an annual premium Brilliant subscription, plus the first 30 days free. Over 50 years later, sterilized flies still rain down from the sky daily, though no longer over the United States. Because screwworms are such fast breeders, the USDA quickly found that to stop new infestations from occurring, they would have to keep airdropping sterilized flies indefinitely. And it wasn't very cost-effective or efficient to keep doing this in the US, when the flies were traveling northward from Mexico and Central America. So in the 1970s, the program was expanded into Mexico, and the US U.S. and Mexican governments wound up splitting the costs of airdropping flies. However, as the years ticked by with no other successful plan in sight, officials continued to look for ways to cut costs. So in a collaborative effort that eventually involved the U.S., Mexico, and all of Central America, a transcontinental screwworm barrier was established in the 1990s at the Darien Gap, a stretch of land on the Panama-Colombia border. Officials figured out that dropping flies on the 97-kilometer stretch of the border between Panama and Colombia was more cost-effective than trying to establish a similar barrier at a narrow part of Mexico that's 220 kilometers across, and it's way better than the 3,200-kilometer border between the US and Mexico. I mean, think about it. Panama is a natural choke point. Screwworms can't cross the ocean, so it cuts off the access to the entirety of North and Central America. As an added benefit, Mexico and all of Central America receive protection from future screwworm infestations. And so, every day, millions of sterilized screwworms are loaded up into planes and dropped over the Panama-Colombia border. These flies are raised in a permanent facility in Panama, and for now, this is the most cost-effective solution. However, scientists are working on new methods to further lower costs and maybe even eradicate screwworms forever. Screwworm infestations are starting to pop back up in Central America, meaning we may need to try something new. One approach currently in the works uses CRISPR to create a gene drive, a sort of self-sustaining genetic poison pill that makes female screwworm flies sterile. Unlike the sterile insect technique, this method spreads naturally through generations, eventually crashing the fly's natural populations. This could be a more sustainable and effective solution in places like South America and Africa, regions that are currently suffering from screwworm infestations without a geographic choke point to contain the flies. And in case you're wondering about the consequences of potentially eradicating the species, well, it seems like no one is too worried about what will happen in the absence of screwworms in particular. Nobody likes those guys. But a lot of scientists do worry about gene drives in general, so that's something that should be figured out. The ongoing fight against screwworms proves how clever scientists' solutions can be, using insects to wipe out their own kind. For decades now, planes have been unleashing millions of flies on Panama, but the future might look a little different. Gene drives could be a game changer in wiping out screwworms for good. If this new approach works, we may have a sustainable, worldwide fix to protect our livestock and wildlife from these tiny but incredibly destructive pests.